What's up guys? I'm going to show you today how you can generate Pinterest pins from any CSV file. So if you're able to export a blog post, products from an e-commerce store, or any other type of information, you can collate it into a CSV file and then generate Pinterest templates from it the way that I'm going to show you here. You can also schedule those templates to go onto Pinterest automatically or download them or pin them directly to Pinterest. So that's what we're going to be covering today. Right, let's jump straight into it. So, head on over here to pingenerator.com. We can see the home page here. Go to the generate page. So we're going to get in this section here. You see where it says enter URL. Just below that, it says upload via CSV. So next to it is the demo file. We're just going to download that so that we can see what we need. Okay, let's open it up. Cool. So here we can see that there's a bunch of columns. Got title, description, URL, URL text, date, and then a sequence of images. So I'm just going to expand those so we can see them all. And we can see that they're all quite straightforward. The URL is the full URL, the URL text. This is a URL without the HTTPS in the beginning, just to make it more legible in the Pinterest templates. This is a date. And then these are image fields with image URLs that you'd like to use. Now, you can have one image, you can have two images, you can have three, you can go four, five, six, seven. Just continue to write out the images as so, image four, etc. So that is the structure of the CSV file. So it's really straightforward. Let's just save that. Let's exit it. And then the uploading. You can simply go upload CSV file. Let's do the demo that we created. And we go create. Cool. So here is the pin that's created. So we can see here that it's used the title, the description, the outbound URL, the short URL text that we said, and then it's got the three images that we set. So we're all set. So that's one pin done. And then, of course, the template settings and the branding settings that it uses are all set up in your sidebar here. So you can select a bunch of templates here, which are the templates that you like. You can select it from your templates or you can select it from the shared templates. You can also add additional images into the pin if you like. You can use AI to rewrite the title and description. So let's say we wanted to do this pin many times over, we could duplicate it, and then we could rewrite all the AI titles, rewrite all the titles with AI to create more unique titles. And yeah, so that's it's a basic run through of how you can use the CSV upload to generate Pinterest pins. So let's do one more example. Let's open up that CSV file, and let's create a unique pin. Let's say my unique pin, test description, www.yourwebsite.com, yourwebsite.com. I'm just going to copy the date from here, and then we'll copy these three images just to make life quick and easy, and save. So if you really wanted to, you could copy this line duplicate it over and over. Let's say you wanted a whole bunch of pins. You could do that. Let's save, let's exit. Let's delete the pins we've got so far. You don't have to, but you just to make things more clear. Let's upload that, upload, boom. And then you've got all your pins being generated. So now once all your pins have been uploaded, you have a few options. You can either pin the pin directly to Pinterest. You can schedule the pin here. You can either add it to your queue or pick a date. You can download the pin. If you're happy with all the pins on the screen, you can simply click this schedule all button. This will schedule all the pins at once. And lastly, if you want to automate this process, you can go hover over the scheduling button, create an auto pin, and create an auto pin. And this pin will generate a new pin from these settings according to a schedule you set. So this is every one day you can create a pin, using all these settings, and here are the possible pins that could be created. You can also turn on AI to rewrite the title each time that you regenerate a pin, so that the pin is always unique. So that's the auto pins too. Cool, I hope that was useful. See you guys in the next one.